What is up, it's Mikey, and as you can see, I got my diamond encrusted vest, royalty camo, and that's what you get when you unlock all the challenges, all the camos for the assault rifles in Advanced Warfare. And that's what we're talking about today, a quick and easy way to get diamond and royalty camo for the assault rifles. So if you want a link to the other weapons, I will have that soon down below, but let's just get into it. So let's go through the challenges in the order. First up is long shots. And here's the setup I used. You don't have to use this, it just worked best for me. The sight that you use on the weapon doesn't really matter too much. Sometimes I use ACOG, a lot of times I use red dot. You can use quick draw or foregrip, and I do recommend the stock. It just helps if you're sort of like tracking someone down. Seems to help a little bit there. Next up, the perks. I'm gonna be using these four perks a lot. Low profile, cold-blooded, blind eye, and hardwired. They basically make you immune to the UAV, the streaks, thermal, all that other stuff. So that way you can focus on your job. We just want to focus on our long shots, or later on we're going to focus on just our headshots. And these four perks are a must if you don't want to deal with kill streaks or any of that stuff. Sentry guns, this just eliminates all that stuff, and then you can customize the rest how you wish. Now, the game mode I do recommend is Hardcore Kill Confirmed, because everyone will die at a distance pretty much in one or two bullets, especially for those burst weapons, the ARX and the IMR. Really important for the single rifle, the MK14, one bullet. I know not everyone has a good trigger finger. Definitely helps out a lot. Kill confirmed, hardcore or softcore, whatever, because you don't want to play domination because you're hurting your team if you're just sitting in the corner. Kill confirmed, your teammates can go fetch the tags. Also, the tags are very tempting for the enemy, and so you can sort of camp those tags at a distance. For my score streak, I do use the UAV pretty much on all the stuff here that we're gonna talk about, and I add the support. So that way, even if you die, you can still earn points towards the UAV and help out you and your team. One thing I'll say is you want to copy and paste the class and work on the next weapon. Like, if you're working on long shots, stay focused on long shots. Headshots, stay focused on that. You don't want to throw off your mojo, right? Once you got your aim down, once you're focused on a certain task, stick to it. That's what I did. That way, once you complete a challenge mid-game, you can go ahead and switch out to that next class and continue doing your long shots or whatever it is that you're working on. All right, next up is the headshots, and it's almost the exact same class, except I have lightweight. And that is because we're gonna be doing a lot of flanking. The game mode that I recommend is Hardcore Domination. I actually hit my all-time high, 34 headshots in a single game. I have a link down below to that gameplay if you wanna watch it. It is just way too easy. Hardcore Domination, there is no UAV up most of the time, and that is how you're able to sneak up on people, because you're not showing up. And headshots are pretty much one bullet to the head. And so you see a lot of clips of me just sneaking up behind people and shooting them. They really have no idea I'm there because I'm not popping up on the radar. And you can get a lot of headshots here really easily. You gotta flank, do a lot of running, and that is why we have the lightweight there. But really, hardcore, I mean, it just has those two big benefits. No UAV constantly up, and one bullet to the head. All right, next up, we need to get 40 strafe medals. And here is my class setup. It's actually really fun. You're gonna be really annoying to people. They're not gonna like you. But yeah, two ARs with the noob tubes on there. We do have lightweight to get in position, the blind eye, so we don't have to deal with score streaks. And we do have the fast hand, so that way we can reload while sprinting, and of course, a support UAV. And what we're gonna play is Hardcore Domination. And it's so easy because with the flags up, you know where people are spawning, you know where they're camping, and you have the increased chance of getting a double strafe kill. Or even right here, I got a triple strafe kill. It is just way too easy, and the noob tubes, they deal so much damage. The way you get a strafe kill is basically by doing a double jump, noob tube somebody, and if they die while you're in the air, boom, it's a strafe kill. It is really easy. I think I got like 23 strafe kills in one game. That was my high. There's just no way you can do that in core. When you run out of noob tubes or buff the guns, you can just do it the old-fashioned way. Just jump around like a crazy rabbit all over the place. You just got to get kills in midair. But the noob tube on Hardcore Domination, that was just way too easy, and expect people to send you hate messages. Next up, we have Bloodthirsty. Get 10 Bloodthirsty medals with this weapon, and that's basically 5 kills in a single life with that weapon. And for that, I recommend full-on stealth, of course a silencer, low profile, cold-blooded, blind eye, and I highly recommend getting the blast suppressor. You just want everything that can help you stay off that mini-map. So the game mode doesn't really matter too much, but I did play Kill Confirmed, Domination. I switched between Hardcore and just Regular. It really depends on the weapon. But really for those burst weapons and the single fire, you really just can't bypass Hardcore. My strategy was playing Hardcore Domination and just sort of patrolling the objective really closely and sticking near walls, just being very cautious so people don't spawn by you. Really, Domination worked the best for me because you know where people are going. You know, you get the announcer, you know, they're taking B, they're taking Alpha. And you can kind of go there and, you know, just sneak up on them while they're trying to capture objective. But really, Hardcore Domination just works so easily for those burst weapons and the MK because there's just no way you can one burst someone midway, long range, silent, in core. You just can't do it. And me personally, I found that easy. You do have to be somewhat aggressive because you need to get to the objective and you need to get those 5 kills before one of your teammates accidentally kills you or you get killed by a random grenade. So it may be a little frustrating. Don't let it get to you, but it's going to happen eventually. Next up, we have Mist Me. Get 40 kills with this weapon shortly after dodging. This is really easy and actually will probably happen on itself over time. All you gotta do is use your little boost movement, your dodge movement, right before you kill someone. Really easy, nothing much to explain there, no special classes, no special mode. Moving on, we have Carbon Fiber. Get 150 kills with this weapon with no perks. And yeah, nothing really special here. You can play whatever your favorite game mode is, whatever attachments. This is what I happen to use. I do have overclock for my exo ability, so that way I can get into their spawn faster. I doubled up on the exo launcher. As soon as I would spawn in, I just dropped 2 random mines, you know, just something to help my KD a little bit. And since we don't have cold-blooded or low profile, any of that stuff, I do have the support UAV just to help out myself and my team. And finally, we have Gold. Get 200 kills with this weapon with no attachments equipped. So you're pretty much going to be Perk Man. Some people even do both the Carbon and the Gold at the same time. So it's just basically you and your gun. You can do that. No special game modes or anything. But obviously, Hardcore is going to be really easy with the harder to use weapons like the MK14 and the Burst. But really, you guys can use whatever you like. And that's what I did. That worked best for me. Again, this is a guide. Feel free to change it up if you like. But I highly recommend the Quadfecta. Low profile, cold-blooded, blind eye, hardwired. It just eliminates all the crap in the game that's going to distract you and you can focus on your job. And then I highly recommend copying and pasting your classes and just focusing on one goal. Focus on your headshots. Focus on your long shots, because that way you're kind of in that zone and you don't get out of it. So that's pretty much it. What weapon should I work on next? Leave a comment below. If you want to play with me, do live streams, open lobbies, Twitter, Facebook is the best way for that. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video, and I'll see you next time. All right, so on the left side there, we have more advanced warfare tips and tricks. Click that. That'll take you to a full playlist. You can check those out. And on the right side, I gotta remind you of Gamefly. I've been using these guys for 2 years. Really great online rental service. That picture is what I tweeted out. They sent me Advanced Warfare on day one. That's the service I use. And they're gonna hook you guys up with a free month trial, a special link down below. It helps you. It helps me.